Welcome back to Let's Play Okami. Last time we finished off Ninetales and got our new objective, which is actually in the northeast part of Shinshu Field. Now we're actually in Yoshima Coast because there's this thing. Remember when we fought that bandit spider in like episode 60 something where we got that sun fragment? It was in the post-commentary episode. After you finish that bandit spider off and do some other story thing, I don't know what that other story thing is though, this appears. This is a devil trial gate, apparently. Apparently this is a major side thing. Let's see, I don't know how tough they are. Oh, Demon Fang without even trying. Also, by the way, we need to grind Demon Fangs. So if you see me taunting the enemies a lot, it's because we need like 200 approximately, because we actually need 80 for one item and I think around 100 for another item. So I will be taunting the daylights out of these enemies because time saving. I mean, I'm gonna have to do this all off screen anyway if I don't collect them here, so I'm going to not, you know, do it on every enemy because that would take until the end of time. But I'm gonna try to do it periodically just to sort of save me time in the long run. I'm low on health. I mean, they call them devil trial gates. I didn't expect them to be easy, but I'm also just playing really carelessly. That's my bad. Also, it appears that enemies do not drop health in these areas. At least that's my current observation. Also, another thing I forgot to do is actually do this. We got a new Clave, so let's actually equip the Blade of Kusanagi now. As a sub, because I like subs, glaives as subs. So we're back to a stabbing attack. I prefer the kind of uppercutty style, personally. It's just, I don't know, it looks cooler. And besides, it just throws off your positioning, too. Okay, so we took quite a bit of damage, so I'm gonna do this. Wow, that restored a lot more than I thought it would. The gate is still here though, unlike a traditional demon gate, or devil gate, whatever it's called. Go back in. We get new enemies. So, think of this kind of comparably to the Pit of 100 Trials, albeit a lot shorter. There are 100 of them to my knowledge. I actually played this one off screen a little bit because I... during that bonus video, I did explore this a little bit, and then I reset afterwards, just so I could show it on screen. I kind of just wanted to look into the whole mechanics of this mode, and once I did that, I could safely stop playing. Because I just thought it was a regular demon gate, so it's like, okay, what's so special about this? Treasure, that's why. Sorry to talk to you soon. Also, I was reading that there are actually quite a few more areas left in the game. So it's like, even though Ninetales is gone and Blight is gone, there's still quite a bit left, really. The game's long. It's usually going to be the longest playthrough on this entire channel, and it's probably going to stay that way until... I don't know, I want to guess Breath of the Wild, because I am doing Breath of the Wild. I'm confirming it right now, I am doing Breath of the Wild. Whenever I feel like it. Most likely because it's gonna be a big game. I wanna kind of feel it out for myself first. Most likely Breath of the Wild will be around June-ish. Potentially earlier, potentially later. It depends on how much I wanna spend on Super Paper Mario, because that's gonna be the next game after this. Because of how bloody long this game is, I've decided that after this we're gonna jump straight into Super Paper Mario. And the problem is, I don't know how much I should show that game. Now that feels weird to say, because I normally do try to get 100%. Some of the cases are like Star Fox 64, I didn't get 100%. You know, SAO Lost Song, I just bailed on, essentially. It's like, I'm done with this game. This game's taking too long. But for the most part, I get 100%. That's my preferred method of Let's Playing, 100% LPs, sort of, yeah, inspired by other people. But, ooh, wow, two demon fangs without any effort. That's rather lucky. Let's actually try this, see how much damage this is. That's actually pretty good. It's slow though, which means I probably won't use it too much because I don't like slow attacks. Yeah. Also, there is another hunt we can actually do. Apparently, I think in Yoshima, there's actually a hunt that opens up now at this point in the game. So we gotta get around to that at some point. One of these days. I keep forgetting to put it off. Like, remember how the, what was that double gate? Not double gate, the monster hunt. Wanted list. There's one, I think it was the one in, I want to say, Kusa Village, that took forever to get around to, just because I kept putting it off. I need to stop doing that. And I am wanting to show as much side content as I can, except for like stray animals and stuff, because that takes forever. Let's be real. Also, if you're following along, even if you're just using this as a trophy guide, potentially, not sure why you would, I think for the trophy, you only need to feed one of each type, so I think we've pretty much covered it. There's like three or four types left, and I don't know how fishing, if there's a fishing trophy or not. So yeah, I mean, going by stands as a PlayStation completion, we're actually doing pretty good. Back in, this is round four, I think. Oh god, these things. Our double bombs will probably come in handy rather quickly. There we go. As I said, double bombs for the win. Bloom. I said bloom. There we go. Now with our upgrade weapons, even these things, actually I think they scale, because we got like a really upgrade weapon, even that took a long time. So I imagine that based on what it feels like it scales. Because we took an unusually, that took an unusually long time to defeat this type, even with our fully upgraded like level 3 thing. And that's an airplane. Just FYI, that's an airplane. Anyway, what was I saying? Yeah, I think enemies scale. That's just my prediction. I have nothing to base it on, but it feels like these enemies are tougher than what these guys should be at this point in the game with our weapons. That's outside island. Weapon list, or whatever you want to say. Like, I feel like this should be going faster. Why isn't this working? Also, something that occurred to me is I've actually never played Metroid for the channel, so probably after Breath of... Like, I might do, like, Zero Mission along with Breath of the Wild or something. That's something I've been bouncing around as an idea in the summer. I kind of wanted to do a Metroid for the 30th anniversary, but the only one is I had Prime, and I wasn't feeling Prime games at that particular time. I can get two of them, right? There we go. Hey, double attack. Okay, so this seems to be the only one left. Also, it doesn't seem like you can do this like after they're already like defeated. You have to do it while they're still alive, which is a lot harder, of course. Taunting a moving target. That was 4, I think, so this would be 5? I think there were 10, if I'm not completely losing my mind. I think there are 10. I want to say there are 10, because that just feels like a good round number. More than because I actually know it's 10. yeah, these enemies are taking an unusually large amount of damage. Wow, 99. Sweet. and wow, maintaining a 99 combo too, that's not the easiest thing in the world to do. My arm is getting really sore, not gonna lie, because I'm just flailing it back and forth over here. Did we get them all? Wow, that was easy. That was the smoothest round so far, bar none. That was easy, because it just comboed the living daylights out of everything that moved. And we got more demon fish. I don't know what these actually are called, but I'm calling them demon fish, because that's what they look like. And more of the swan things. All the enemy types kind of run together in my mind after a while, so yeah. If I mess up the names, or frankly don't know the names, yeah, that's probably why. I actually really am enjoying the game in a lot of ways. I don't know if I'd ever play Okami Den, just because it's really, really hard to find, and it also have to just be on my own time, because quite frankly, there's no way I am recording Okami Den, because of how 3DS capture works, how expensive it is, and everything. Okami Den for Switch, please. Hell, an Okami collection for Switch would be pretty dang cool, just saying. Yeah, I have no real desire to like really delve into Capcom games stuff from this, like, oh, Beautiful Joe, for example, just never really appealed. Even though Beautiful Joe is you know, considered a legitimately good game, it just never personally appealed to me. So yeah, that's why I probably would not be likely to play that game anytime soon. I don't know it either. And I don't know if with Beautiful Joe, if they've ever actually re-released it, so you'd have to get like a GameCube copy. We all know how expensive GameCube games are. A GameCube game is easily the most expensive game I own. I actually do have the Mega Man X collection for GameCube. I think it even has the manual and everything. And like, it was like 90 bucks, but it was like, frankly, 90 bucks is good for Mega Man X on GameCube, because that game can go up to like 150, 200 easily, and it's in pretty good shape too, so yeah, it's more, I bought it for GameCube just because it's a collector's item, even though the PS2 version was about like 4 times less. Just, you know, value-wise, the GameCube version holds up better. Plus, I have a working GameCube. And I don't actually have a working PS2 at the moment, so if you want proof, you can look up my playthrough of the first hour of Final Fantasy IX and see that the game was kind of falling apart at the seams. It's sad, because I do really like the game, but it was really falling apart in that video. Did really bum me out, because it's like, it's such a good game, and yet the capture was just not having any of it. Not the capture, the PS2 was having none of it. 9 is my favorite. If I were to revisit that, it would be a while, because quite honestly, that game is long as heck, and I wouldn't want to go from one 40-hour game to another right off the bat. Cough, breath, and wild cough. But yeah, like Super Paper Mario, I'm estimating, should only take about, maybe 40 videos, depending on how I format it. I'm thinking about going by chapter, just for continuity, but going by chapter also creates the issue of having some episodes being exponentially longer than others. And plus you have the chapter interlogs. I don't know what to call these, but like, the in-between chapter stuff. Like, how you do that. Do you tack it on to the end of chapter 4? Or do you tack it on to the beginning of chapter, or the end of chapter, wait. What am I saying? Do you tack it on to the end of chapter 4, or do you tack it on to the beginning of chapter 1? So it's like, I don't know if there's really a good way to do it that way, so I might go by like 20 minutes. But even then, it shouldn't take that long. Super Paper Mario is not that long of a game. I'd say it's shorter than Bowser Door, at least. But yeah, for me, the game is not as good, but the plot carries it really well. So that's why I'd play it for the plot. Which always felt weird to me, actually playing a Mario game for the plot. Because Mario just doesn't seem right, really. Oh yeah, I'm almost dead actually. Gotta be a little bit more cautious. I am kind of rushing at this point because I am kind of running low on time, and I think we still have a few more gates left in this set, and I'd kind of like to have them all in one video. If not, it happens. We'll just finish it off next time and do other Ryoshima coast things in the next episode. But I would really like to get through this double gate in 20 minutes. Oh, these guys are tanky. Like, I don't remember these guys tanking hits like that. But yeah, it definitely feels like they're scaling. Okay. Is the gate... Okay, I was just having weird despawn. Yeah. I'm gonna do this because cost efficiency. I'm gonna attempt to finish one more. Oh, these guys. These guys are easy to take out. Just slash at the little thingies and then you go down really easily. Yeah, like look at how we're comboing these guys. And also there's just the like gray imps. And I mean the orange imps, the red imps I think is what they're called, with the gray imps. So this is actually really easy. Like this feels a lot easier than the previous round. Sort of disproportionately so. Yeah, that's the problem I have with a lot of games, and it feels like Okami has this issue as well. Weird difficulty scaling at times. Like sometimes it gets disproportionately easy and hard at a moment's notice, and it doesn't really make sense. Like look how much better that went. Like that was so easy compared to the previous one. So how many has it been? I've completely lost count. I have completely lost. Oh shoot. So the best thing to deal with these guys is to slow down. Oh wait, that's the other type of wheel, isn't it? Wait, these guys are on fire, so if I do this. Oh, a fire wheel on top of an ice wheel. That's what it was. Okay, there we go. They're not burning anymore, so. There we go. I hope it's just these types of wheels, not the other ones, on top of the other wheels. I feel like these guys are really annoying because of the spacing, because they kind of, it's hard to maneuver, really. And slowing down time doesn't help with them, which is the most annoying thing, is that unlike the other types of wheel type enemies, we can't really do a whole lot to reduce the issue here. They're just kind of annoying. No two ways about it. And they take a lot of hits, it seems. We're probably gonna just come back at the end of this fight, because you've seen these. So we're just gonna kind of rejoin when we're probably through this. Because there are no new enemy types, and you see what we've gotten ourselves into, essentially. Yeah. And thus, thank you for watching. Oh, wait. One is weakened. Can I... That did not do very much damage at all. That did a lot less than I was hoping. So that was disappointing. I'm just gonna tank hits pretty much, and this is gonna be more of this for like a very long time. So, thank you for watching, and I hope you join me next time for more Okami.